Hi, I'm Craig Frazier. I'm going to show you some reduction techniques using Wicked colors. Now we got a little bottle of Wicked orange right here. Always give it a shake. I don't care which paint you've got. You always shake it up. They always can tend to settle. And we're going to pour a little right into our cup. Now, why would you actually rather mix in a cup than just in a bottle? Well, when you mix in a cup, you can actually see what you're doing a little bit better. You can add other colors to it. I'm going to add some 40-12 reducer right in here. How much? Oh, I'd say between 5 to 10%. You can add more, but you can always start out with 5 to 10%. You can always add more if you need it. Give it a good little stir. And when it's all said and done, got a nice mix there that we can take and put in our bottle and squeeze right into the airbrush. Okay, we showed the real simple reduction of just adding 40-12 to the Wicked colors. Let's take it up a notch. Now, what am I doing with this? We're actually gonna add some Balance and Clear, some 40-30. And what this does, it makes the paint a little bit more durable, adds adhesion to it, makes the paint dry a little bit better, even makes it more sprayable, more tapeable. And when would you wanna use that? Well, if you're working on a hard surface or you're working on something that may be questionable for adhesive, shoes, canvases, some types of leathers, the 40-30 just really makes the paint a lot stronger. And the great thing is you can add more 40-30 to your paint to reduce the color strength down, you know, by actually making it more translucent, and it doesn't make the paint any weaker, it actually makes it stronger. So we had that original bottle here. Now we could just go ahead and take our 40-30, just add it right to this bottle. And you're never gonna add too much. The worst it'll ever do is it'll be really faint color-wise, but it won't be any less strong. If you just add reducer to your paint, and just to make it really, really thin, that paint can actually start becoming weak and become what's called binder pour, where the pigments start breaking down, it won't stick, it sprays badly, it doesn't dry well. So basically, this is a great way that helps you get a translucency without over reduction. What I'd recommend doing if you haven't mixed paint yet is to go ahead and take your 40-30, give it a shake. I know it's not color, it still has some different products in there that can stratify, and you wanna make sure you shake everything except for your reducers. Shake your reducers, they can make little bubbles that causes problems. So our 40-30 there, let's take our 40-12, it's the recommended reducer of choice. How much am I adding in? 5, maybe 10% at the most. Don't need a whole lot with that. And give it a good stir. Then I'll come in with my pigment. How much? I'd go about 50-50, maybe a little bit less. Don't need a lot in there. And give it a stir. You see how it literally just mixes really nice right away. When that's all said and done, we can, if you want, you can just take it and add it to your bottle. So give it a good shake and that's ready to airbrush. So there's some great little tricks and ideas. Hope you've enjoyed them and I'll see you next time.